Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to the video series History of English Literature. This is the chapter 14 of the video series. In this video, I will discuss modern age or the interwar years. So previously, I have uploaded videos starting from the Anglo-Saxon period to the birth of modern literature. So if you haven't watched those videos, please check out the playlist History of English Literature. You will get all the videos together there. So now let's talk about today's video, that is on modern age or interwar years. The duration of this age is from 1918 to 1939. So first, let's see the historical and social context of this age. So this period is basically the time between the First World War and the Second World War. So in this period, we can see the after effects of the First World War and the forebodings of the Second World War. So in this period, we can also see the Great Economic Depression. And society appears to be breaking down. We can see the sense of loss, especially of a moral order. And women and working class became more organized from this age. And we can also see rapid changes in society, politics, and technology. So first, let's see the novelist of this age. Then we will see the poets of this age. Then we will see the dramatist of this age. So now let's see, discuss the novelist of this age. First, there is D.H. Lawrence. His full name is David Herbert Lawrence. So he provides psychological explorations in the leaps of the characters. Especially, we can see Oedipal complex in his novels like Sons and Lovers. So what is Oedipal complex? I will discuss later in a separate video. So we can also see autobiographical elements in his novels. His major novels are The White Peacock, Sons and Lovers, The Rainbow and its sequel Women in Love, Lady Chatterley's Lover, Kangaroo, The Plumed Serpent, etc. Next novelist is James Joyce. He was a central figure in the modernist prose. He was born in Ireland. And he was deeply interested in the mediums and the forms of art. His first work was Dubliners. And he also wrote an autobiographical novel, Stephen Hero, which was later called, which is later known as A Portrait of the Artist as a Young Man. And his most famous novel is Ulysses. Virginia Woolf is one of the most important writers of this age. And she married the writer Leonard Woolf. And she was the member of a Bloomsbury group. In her novel, she emphasizes private life like loneliness, love, friendship, art, and he ignores the external social reality. Her famous novels are The Voyage Out, Jacob's Room, Mrs. Dalloway, To the Lighthouse, Orlando, A Biography, A Room of One's Own, which is a masterpiece of feminist writing, etc. Next novelist is Aldous Huxley. Aldous Huxley's famous works are Chrome Yellow, Antique Hay, Those Barren Leaves, Brave New World, which is a dystopian novel, and Eyeless in Gaza, etc. And another novelist of this age is George Orwell. His real name is Eric Arthur Blair. Please remember this because they can ask this question that whose real name was Eric Arthur Blair? So the answer will be George Orwell. His famous works are Animals from 1984, etc. Now let's see the poets of this age. The most important poet of this age is T.S. Eliot. He was a poet, critic, and a playwright also. He was the pioneer of the modernist movement. He was born in USA and he left America in 1914 and settled in London. He got Nobel Prize in Literature in 1948. His famous poems are The Love Song of J. Alfred Prufrock, The Wasteland, The Hollow Man, etc. All of these poems are very, very important. And his famous dramas are Sweeney Agonistes, The Murder in the Cathedral. This Murder in the Cathedral is a very important drama. And The Family Reunion, The Cocktail Party, etc. And he also wrote some works on criticism, like The Sacred Wood, The Function of Criticism, Homage to John Dryden, etc. Let's see the next poet, that is G.M. Hopkins. He was a Roman Catholic convert and a Jesuit priest. He created Sprung Rhythm. Please remember this. And he wrote Cartel Sonnets. Cartel Sonnets is a sonnet which has 10.5 lines. And examples of the Cartel Sonnets which he wrote are Piet Beauty, As Bow, Peace, etc. His major poems are God's Grandeur, Wind Hover, Spring and Fall, Clarion Comfort, etc. Another important poet of this age is W. H. Auden. His famous works are Musée des Beaux-Arts, In Memory of W. B. Yeats, The Unknown Citizen, September 1, 1939, In Memory of Sigmund Freud, etc. And other poets of this age who were famous are Stephen Spender, C. J. Lewis, Louis MacNeis, etc. Let's see the dramatists of this age. First, there comes Saulo Cassi. His major dramas are Shadow of a Gunman, The Plow and the Stars, The Silver Tessie, Juno and the Peacock, etc. And next, there is William Somerset Maugham. His major dramas are A Man of Honor, The Lady Frederick, Mrs. Todd, Jack Straw, Home and Beauty, The Circle, Our Betters, The Constant Wife, etc. So this was all about the modern age. I have discussed the major novelists, major poets, and the major dramatists of this age. I hope you have found this video helpful. If you have found this video helpful, please like, comment, and share with your friends. And please subscribe the channel if you haven't done it. And in the next video, we will discuss the last chapter of the history of English literature, that is postmodern age. And after that, this series will be completed. Thank you for watching.